Our next speaker is Ivan Vilatayi-Balaguer, and he will be talking about Community Lab.
Thank you. Well, I'm Ivan. I am from the Pangea NGO, and I work for the Confine project. I'm going to here to talk about this Community Lab testbed for experimenting on community networks. For those of you that are unfamiliar with community networks, this kind of networks is infrastructure deployed by organized groups of people for providing themselves with broadband networking that grows and works according to their own necessities. So in some terms, they are quite similar to free software. They are open in participation. They are as well open and transparent in management. And they follow a distributed ownership model, which certainly goes beyond the state-owned model of infrastructure plus private ISPs. It goes as well beyond the private infrastructure plus private access model. And in community networks, each user owns a part of the infrastructure. And all users are free to access all the services that run on top of that community network. So this results in a model of network that is open, free as in freedom, and neutral, which are concepts which are quite similar to those in free software. In fact, some community networks use written mutual agreement texts, which are quite similar to free software licenses. And strange as it may seem, the European Union regards this kind of community networks as fundamental for the popularization or the universalization of broadband networking in Europe for the year 2020. So, under the umbrella of this digital agenda, the Confine project is a European Union-funded project with several partners in several countries in Europe. There are some community networks, of course. We have Gifinet, mainly from Spain, Catalonia. The Athens Wireless Metropolitan Network from Greece. Funfoyer from Austria. We have also research centers, the Universitat Politecnica de Catalunya, the iMinds from Hofer, and there are a couple of supporting NGOs, Pangea, and the O-Plan Foundation. So the mission of the Confine project itself is to support the sustainable growth of this kind of community networks by putting in place the means to conduct experimental research on this kind of networks. It also supports other projects that help community networks grow through financed open calls. We see here the list of the five currently running projects in the first open call, and we are selecting a set of more than 15 projects for the second one. And last but not least, of course, is the Confine provides the community lab testbed for supporting the experimentation of network technologies and services on top of community networks. This community lab testbed is an environment with real hardware, which runs on actual community networks, and it provides the support for realistic experiments that run on real community networks, as I mentioned. It's like Planet Lab, for those of you that know it, in terms that it's global scale, in that experiments share the same resources in a best effort basis, and also in that it implements the very least set of hardware management mechanisms. But in exchange, it's heavily customized for community networks. In particular, for its distributed ownership model, for the fairness between users, And it's diversity, but it's instability as well. And very importantly, all the software and the documentation for Community Lab is free as in freedom, so anyone can build their own testbed. So how does this testbed work? Well, it mainly consists of a set of nodes which are managed by community network members, and those nodes follow the configuration set in a set of servers which are run by testbed operators. And all the components in the testbed become reachable through a dedicated management network, which is implemented as an IPv6 overlay. Then we have the researchers, which define the experiments on some server. These experiments are called slices in this terminology. And we have the nodes that use a REST API to fetch the definitions of these experiments and run several of them simultaneously as virtual machines, which we call slivers. Then these slivers are able to use or to access the community network via NAT or via native layer 3 network networking, or they can communicate between themselves in an isolated VLAN tagged network for routing experiments. These nodes are basically medium, moderately powerful computers, as this bare bones computer, which are attached via plain Ethernet to normal community devices, that is routers. And they run the OpenWRT operating system plus a control daemon, which is implemented in Lua. These slivers, the virtual machines, are implemented as very light Linux containers. And we are also working on the safe upgrade of these nodes using KXSEC. For the graphical user interface and the REST API from servers, they are implemented as Django applications. And the IPv6 overlay used as the management network is a Tink Mesh VPN. Besides that, we use the usual, Git, Redmine, Jenkins, and the virtual confined testbed packets for the development and the testing of everything. Okay. But besides the experimentation, the confined project also supports the extension of the community networks themselves, both by providing new nodes in the form of community lab nodes or links. And beyond that, we also provide hosting for services in the same nodes. These services can be web servers or video broadcast stations for the use of the community, whatever. And more sophisticated, we can implement, or we can use the community lab as cloud infrastructure provided, both provided and managed by the community for the same community. And this is the mission of this. So this is a broader project called Community. Okay. Confine also supports the development of other free software projects, in particular the OpenWRT distribution, the BMX6 and OLSR mesh networking protocols, the DLEP protocol for gathering network characteristics, low-level network characteristics, the NodeDB, which is a database with an API for storing the information of community network nodes, and the YBED testbed, which is a lower level testbed. And the QuickMesh project, which is a distribution to easily set up mesh networks. It also participates in some mesh networking and community networking events, like the Wireless Battle Mesh and the International Summit for Community Wireless Networks. Well, in the future, we plan to work more on the testing, the stabilization, and the documentation of the testbed itself, so it becomes more manageable and more sustainable in the long term. We will start also working this year with the Federation of testbeds, both confined testbeds among themselves, although now there's one big testbed, which is Community Lab, but we run other testbeds for testing and the like. And we also work on the federation with Planet Lab-like testbeds using the slice-based federation architecture. And finally, we will be gradually opening the Community Lab testbed to other users besides those in the open call, as networking developers or even the academic community. But of course, you are able to set up your own testbed as well with the same software. Well, really, there's not much more to say. We have a stand in the K building on the second floor. And if you are interested in community networks or confined project or the Community Lab testbed, then you are welcome to drop by there and ask us or ask myself whatever you want. So that's it from my part. I hope you you get interested at least in the concept of community networks, because we think we have lots of things in common with free software, and it's a topic that is a little bit left behind in the postman. So that's it. Thank you. Yeah, we have some time for questions. If you have something.
Somebody.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Ivan.